I will teach you about conceptual dependency representation, okay? And to make you understand this, I will give you few examples so that the representation will become clear to you. First example is as written here, is John ran, and you have to make conceptual dependency representation for John ran. So here ran is the word from which you will get that it is the transfer of physical location. When John was running, he moved from one location to another location. So this is P trans. So you will get to know about the primitive action from this. So here primitive action that must have to be used will be P trans. Okay, because it is transfer of physical location. Now you have to understand one thing, that whenever we are having actions and an object, we have to use bidirectional arrow. And how we will represent this arrow is like this. This arrow indicates that it is bidirectional. Okay, this is bidirectional arrow. So whenever we have actions and an object, object may be noun or verb relation, then we have to use the bidirectional arrow. Here John is a noun and he is performing an action which is ran. He was running. So here we have to use bidirectional arrow. Okay, now I hope you understand this, why we will use bidirectional arrow here. The reason is, here we have a noun and we have an action. John is an actor and he is performing the action of running. Okay, now this, understand this sentence. This is in past tense. Ran indicates that this sentence is in past tense. So to represent past tense, we will use this P keyword. Okay, now I will make the representation. So conceptual dependency representation will be like this. You don't need to write any arrow, just write the answer. So you have to write it like this, John, and then double arrow, which indicates that here we have a noun and an action performed by that noun. And here you have to write P, which indicate that it is in past tense, and you have to write here P trans. Here it is N also. Okay, so here John P to indicate past tense and then P trans. This is for your understanding purpose. You don't need to write this. The answer will be this only. Okay, John double arrow, and above that we have to write P to represent that it is in past tense and then P trans. Okay, so this is the representation of this subject. Now our next sentence is tall John. This sentence represent that John is a tall boy. As at this time, it become an adjective. This is tall will become an adjective, which is representing that John is a tall. So we have to represent it like this. You have to write here John. Okay, and you have to use only one arrow, and which will go from this like this, John, and you have to write here tall. Okay, why we have written it like this, I will tell you now. See, tall is an adjective which is here representing that John is a tall boy. So whatever the adjective we have to write it downwards, and the noun it representing, we have to write it upwards, and we have to use the arrow upward, in upward direction. Okay, some people confused here and they use downward arrow. So you don't have to do this. The adjective you have to write in downside and arrow will go upwards. Okay, so don't get confused in these types of sentences. Here also we don't have to use any of the primitive action. And it is not compulsory that in all of the sentences you have to have a primitive action. Like this, in this you don't have any primitive action. But here you have used a primitive action ptrans. Okay. Now third sentence. Third sentence is John is tall. Okay. Here also this is representing that this sentence is representing that John is a tall boy. But understand one thing, which is here it is not acting as an adjective. Okay, this tall is not acting as an adjective like in this sentence. So here you have is relation. Is relation come between. Okay, John and tall. Here we have between John and tall there is a relation. And whenever we are having is a relation between two classes, it will become a class John and tall will also become a class. Tall is not a class. John is a class. John will become a class and tall cannot become a class. Here we have is relation. And for tall, we don't have any modifier. We don't have any primitive action for tall to represent tall. Also, tall can't be used as a class. Okay. So, we have to create a new class in this. I will create a new class height and I will use triple arrows. Why I have used this like this? One line, two line, three line and then double-sided arrows. This is not bidirectional relation. This is the relation that comes between two classes. I have made a class John and another class height. And to represent is a relation between two classes, we have to use arrows like this. Okay. And why I have used this. Okay. So I will tell you now. See, if John's height is greater than average height. If the height of a person is greater than the height of average person, it indicates that John is tall. So this sentence is a bit confusing, I know that, but you have to represent these types of sentences, you have to make a new class, because tall can't be used as a modifier, and the relation between two classes will be represented by this arrow. One line, two line and three line and both double-sided arrows. Okay. So, create a class height. If height of John is greater than average, then he is tall. This will represent this. Okay. Now, next sentence. Now, next sentence is John is a doctor. Okay. This is the new sentence. So here is a relation is there. John can be a class. Doctor can be a class. Okay. So for is a relation, to represent relation between two classes, we have to use these kinds of arrow. One line, two line, three line and both double-sided arrows. Here you have to write John. And here you have to write doctor. Okay. Here it is in small sentences or the grammatical things. John is a doctor. So this will be the representation of this. Because here we have a is a relation and also John is a class, doctor is a class, doctor can be a class. So you have to write it like this. Now next sentence is a nice boy. So it is the next sentence. Now, nice will represent adjective. Okay. So, I have told you already that how to represent this. You have to write here boy and then the adjective downside. Nice. And use the arrow upwards. So, this is a representation of this. As nice is an adjective, so you have to write it like this. Now next sentence, which is John's dog. It means that John is a dog. He is possessing something, which is dog. Okay. So for this, you have to represent it in a different way. Nothing relation is here. Okay. Here, there is no primitive action. and there is no relation. Is a relation, or he can't have any other kind of relation. So here you have to write it like this. John. Okay, write John. And what he is processing, you have to write it like this. See this double arrow, double lines, and then a arrow. Okay, this like this, and what he is possessing, you have to write it upwards. This John is possessing a dog, and to represent that line that he is possessing a dog, you have to write here pause by. Okay, he is possessing a dog. Maybe there is some spelling mistake here, but I hope you understand this. This you don't have to write, but just I'm writing this. John is possessing a dog. So to represent this, you have to write here pause by, and John double lines, arrow will go upwards. What he is possessing, you have to write here in after the arrow, which is dog. So don't get confused. This is also a different kind of sentence. Now next sentence, I will tell you. Next sentence is a bit difficult, but if you will understand this, you can make different kinds of conceptual dependency representations. John pushed the cart. See, here pushed is the force that he is applying. And for the pushed keyword, you have to use a primitive action, which is propel, P-R-O-P-E-L. This is the key primitive action that you have to use for the push keyword. So this is a bit different, and how you have to use it, I will tell you now. It will become an noun, and it will become an action. Pushed, and so here we have it will become an action, it will become a noun. So here you have to use double arrows. Like this. Okay, so John, what he has done, what action he has performed is pushed, and to represent pushed, you have to use propel, primitive action, P-R-O-P-E-L. Okay, and what he has pushed, you have to represent it like this. The object is O, and it is cart. John pushed the cart. So you have to represent it like this. O represent object, and the object is cart. Okay, and here you have to write P. Why you have to write P here? Because push is in past tense. So to represent past tense, you have to write P just above this arrow. And here in above this arrow, you have to write O. O will represent object. Okay, object here is cart. Okay, so you don't have to write this. Just I'm telling this. So this is the complete answer, okay, of this sentence. I hope you got this. Our eighth sentence is John took the book from Mary. So here he has taken book from the Mary. Okay, and took is in past tense. First of all, the sentence took is in past tense, and here a tense will be used because it is transfer of an abstract thing. Mary has given the book to the John. So here a trans, A-T-R-A-N-S, a trans will, primitive action will be used, and it is in past tense, so you have to use small p for that, and the object is book, so you have to use small o for that, and rest everything I will tell you how you have to write that. First of all, write here John. And here we have a relation, like actor has performed the action of taking the book. So action is took. So you have to use double arrows, double lines, and double sided arrows. And here you have to write a trans. Okay, actor has performed the action. This is noun, this is action, and you have to use this kind of representation for this, and above this you have to write P, which represent that this is in took is in past tense. Okay, after this the object that is used is book. Book is the object that is being taken. Okay, After that, you have to also represent that who has taken which thing from whom. So to represent that, you have to use arrows like this, just to, this you don't have to write, okay? You have to write it like this. I will tell you, firstly, just see what I am doing. You have to represent it like this. And here you have to write to, here you have to write from, okay? This is from, F-R-O-M. This is to, this is from, and now see. Book is taken from Mary. So you have to write here Mary. Book is taken from Mary. And it is given to John. So you have to write here John. This arrow will be like this. This arrow will be like this. So here it is clearly specified that John has taken book from Mary. So you have also have to include this also. Mary, from Mary book has been taken and it is given to John, okay? Or other way to represent this can be just write here John, and this thing will remain same, and here you have to write A trans, okay? And here you have to write O, and here you will do like this. Just see what I am doing, then I will explain you. And here you have to write John, here you have to write Mary, here you have to write to, and here from. Now see this. A trans is there and object will become book. So what is this? What I have done here? I have done that. There you have don't have to write anything. This part of this whole I have written it like here only. Everything will be same. Just cut this part and you can write it like this also. Okay, if you want to represent it like the object in this way, you can represent that also. Okay, I hope you got this. I have just taken this one and written it here. Now next sentence. See, the next sentence is John ate ice cream with a spoon. Okay. So you have to represent conceptual dependency representation for this. First of all, ate sentence is in past tense. He is eating something. So he is taking something inside into his body. So here ingest, I-N-G-E-S-T, ingest primitive action will be used. And it is used in those cases where something is taken inside our into our body. So here ice cream is taken inside. So ingest will be used. So and this is in past tense. And here we have a noun and an action is performed, which is eating ice cream. So here you have to write it like this. John, and then double lines and then double sided arrows, and which ate is in past tense. So here light, here P, and here ingest. Ingest will be used to represent this ate. This is so easy sentence. After this, you have to do what you have to do, I will tell you. So you have to write it like this. As already I have told you, like you can write represent objects like this. You can write here object, and object here is spoon, sorry, ice cream. What he has used is ice cream, like this. And you can write it like this. This is a different, difficult kind of way, but I am telling you, in some textbooks and some places it is written like this. Firstly, let me write it, then I will explain it to you. Okay. So I will tell you another way also. You can draw it easily in that way. First, just see this way. Here John is eating an object which is ice cream, and John has done it using a object called spoon. So here I have written do and double arrow, double lines, and then one arrow. this is also a way of representing this sentence. But if you want another way, so you can represent it like this, or you can represent it like this: John, double arrows. It will be an easy way. Here you have to return P, and then ingest, and then O, and then ice cream. And here you can write it like this: with, and here you can write this as spoon. This is a simpler one, no? So this object will become ice cream, and with the help of spoon. Here in this sentence we have taken two objects, like he has taking object ice cream inside into his body, and then he has done that work using the object spoon. But here I have used only one object, which is ice cream, and with spoon. I have not written any object here. And another way in which you can represent it, but it is also a bit different, difficult, you can say, you can write it like this: past tense. Is like this: ingest. Okay, and here you have to write O. This is ice cream, and here just write here John, and this will become move and spoon. Here I have used two primitive actions. Like when he is trying to eat that ice cream, he will move his arms. And if John will move his hand to pick the spoon. So here move primitive action will be used. Okay. This is spoon. So in this way you can represent it also. But this way is a simpler one. So just do it in whatever way you want, but just understand one thing: the representation must have to be done in a way that I have explained you, and that you can see from your books. Okay, that's it.